There's certain questions in physics that they tend to be why questions, where an answer is not always obvious. My name is Neil deGrasse Tyson. I'm an astrophysicist with the American Museum of Natural History in New York City. The question of why are we going into space, one of them is, maybe you want to know how to deflect that asteroid that would render us extinct. That's a good reason to go into space. Maybe you want to tap the asteroids that are rich in minerals so that you can become the world's first trillionaire. That would be a good reason to go into space. 3/4 of all money spent on space today is for commercial products, for industries that use GPS, for weather satellites, for communication satellites, direct TV. So maybe you'll go into space because you want to make money in some kind of telecommunications industry. There could also be geopolitical reasons that have to do with cooperation, that have to do with demonstrations of a capacity to collaborate. But you know what I think the best reason for going into space is? It's, though we have problems here on Earth, just imagine we're all in a cave. We're cavemen. There you are. We're in a cave. And I say, I like to go out the cave and explore what's across the valley and over the hills. And then you come to me and say, nope, can't do that. We have problems in the cave. Got to fix the cave problems first. That has high priority. You can't go out beyond the cave. You hear how absurd that exchange is. If the sun were hollow, you could pour 1 million Earths into the hollow sun and still have room left over. So, to suggest that somehow space is of no interest because it cannot serve our interests is embarrassingly short-sighted. I don't think colonization is in our future. I think we'll have outposts eventually on the moon and Mars, and you'll go and visit them on a tourist jaunt. That will be fun. I'd save up for that. Any of us would save up for that. Maybe you want to go into space because there's science to learn. How would that affect you today? It won't. There's no contribution to your existence today. But we may discover something in space that will matter in the future. That some clever technologist will say, oh, there's a new physics principle that you've revealed in space. Let me convert it in such a way that it has value to us on Earth.